Right, where were we then?
Last October, I set off on an expedition into Tasmania's southwest wilderness in search of a gravesite of a 19-year-old piner who was drowned in the Jane River region 120 years ago. Misinformation on maps slowed progress, with topography and streams wrong in many places. And it's not just one map, every map has it wrong. You see, the best pine was reported between the Jane and Thurkell's Creek, and I imagine the piners had their camp somewhere there. When Stannard was drowned, he was carried 3 miles back to the camp and buried nearby. If we can find the camp, we might be able to find the gravesite. Whilst researching, I discovered a report on the area, in which an old track used by prospectors is described. At Stannard's grave, approximately 6 miles from Calder's Pass, the track turns sharply to the left, and after crossing a short stretch of button grass, it follows close to the bank of the Jane River. With this new information, I was ready to go, so I rallied up the lads to give it another crack. We decided this time we'll incorporate pack rafts into the trip, and with a bit of luck, this will save our legs for the big search ahead. The new plan was simple. Following the New Jane River track, we'll hike all day and set up camp on the banks of the Erebus Rivulet. From here, we'll pack raft down to the junction of the Jane, where we can turn off and paddle upstream to find the old Piner's camp, hopefully located on Thurkell's Creek. Using this as a base, we'll explore the remaining Stannard's Flats area. I believe the gravesite should be in the south, the only area in which we haven't explored. Once we find the grave, we'll document it before retracing our route and heading back to civilization.
Nice of you to join us.
Yeah, the cafe was a little bit late.
Blame the cafe.
This is a third wheel, is it, Levi?
Can't believe we're walking the Jane track today, boys. It's been a while, hasn't it?
Bit of anxiety.
Nah, we got so much good weather ahead of us. I think this is going to be lovely.
We were just looking at the weather. We're a little bit pessimistic, I will admit. But it is, from yesterday to today, the report has improved.
Yeah. That's good. Yeah. That's pretty mellow. I mean, Surprise River was double this.
That day we tried to cross it.
The day we tried to cross it, yeah. And that, so Surprise will be literally like that little bit over there. That's just ankle.
It'll be knee high and cold and clear.
You said it would be impassable. Can we go home already?
I did not. You lied.
She looks nice.
I'm excited to get out there.
Gotta wake these poor people up. Does anyone need gloves? Or spare pair?
I'm good on gloves. Thanks, mate.
Locking.
Lock it up. Let's go and start this trip, boys. Let's finish what we started, eh?
Yep. Definitely.
Time to roll.
See you, Subi.
Running wild and running free.
Man, what a day. So we've made it to the Erebus Rivulet. We arrived here about half hour ago, just as it was getting dark, and set up camp and had a bite to eat. We were completely saturated. The walk today was very similar to the last time we walked out of here in the rain. Like, there was just huge puddles everywhere. Everything was super slippery. Couldn't trust anything. And Hugh's hip started playing up, so he called it at the Loddon River, and he said he's gonna head back home and go get picked up. So we arranged for his wife to come and get him with the satellite phone, and she came and picked him up. He got out of here at about 4:30, I think. He wrote to us to tell us that. So the plan tomorrow is to go ahead with the pack rafting a bit further downstream from where we are, but yeah, need to get some Z's. I'm zonked. See you in the morning.
Oh, how you feeling, Levi?
Yeah, I'm alright. I'm super sore, but
yeah. Yeah, super sore. So it's just like my hips and my legs, I think, are like aching. I don't know if it's to do with the cold or so, whatnot. I didn't really get super amount of like good constant sleep. You remember how fresh these boots were at the start of Jane 2.0? Mm.
They'd like that though, but
safe to say they've been through hell and back. With a sprinkling of heaven.
So I think what we've decided to do is, since we've got the pack rafts, we're going to use them. And we're just going to try and run this choked up log jam section, because we really can't be bothered getting wet. And if we bush bash, even if it's only 2.5-3 k's, we're going to be soaked to the bone again by the time we get into the water. Or we can just utilize the pack rafts, jump in the water now and begin the pack rafting leg. So that's the plan. Hopefully it doesn't bite us.
Hopefully it works.
But if it does, we'll just have to wear it.
Like the wind on my face, I can feel you, but my eyes can't see you.
I reckon it's time to
like the radio waves,
really send it.
I can hear you, but my hands can't hold you.
Want it?
I'm not afraid to die.
That was on the rock, eh?
Hey?
That was on the rock.
Big one.
Far out.
That's the end of our rafting for today.
Yeah, so Levi was just doing this log crossing where I'm at, and he had the raft set up here. This is bedrock here, what you can see that's poking out. And he had the raft sitting on the bedrock, and he went to jump in on it to slide into the water, and I saw him paddling off to the side, and his raft was just like losing air at a fast rate. So we vessel down. Ah, shit.
That changes things
a lot. I'll just let me get out here. I'll have see what it looks like.
I mean, I'm happy that if you want to keep going through, like, I can make it out.
Fuck, I don't know. Just so close, like, this is the point where it's like...
My feeling is we're still not close to where we want to be.
I think
if we were at the junction, if we had got to the junction, it gives us a chance, but...
Being this close to the hut, you reckon that...
Yeah, just take it as like a omen or whatever, but... Is that the word?
An omen.
It's a sign. But I don't really want to go to the hut. I mean, I'd rather just get back to the track and make some ground up. Have a less big walk tomorrow, like I walk to the dark, and then set up camp somewhere on the track. Maybe back up at the Erebus. Is that ridiculously
hard? No.
I don't think anyone would think we were... Like, I think it's got a video in itself, what we've done.
It's a short video.
Well, no, it's probably got 20, 30 minutes, and maybe got content. I don't know. You can go on alone, man, if you want to keep grafting, because you've got an opportunity to do it. I can walk out. I'll be fine. I've got my maps. I've got both maps. Give you an opportunity to do it, but I'd say you'd be taking a risk on your own, that's all. But you're used to this sort of thing, like you've done a lot more of it than me, so you kind of give you an opportunity to do it.
I know, I just feel it doesn't sit right with me to split. And one, if we do it, and once we split up, I don't know, we've got no form of contact, you know?
Yeah, but you can send a message saying Levi's going to make the walk out, should be out by tomorrow night. All going well. I've got my e-perl. You're able to go, continue on with your raft and make some ground. I don't know, that's just an idea, but probably not a wise one for either of us. It's always safer in numbers if, you know. I don't know.
Yeah,
something.
It's a big, big journey.
On your own.
Thank you. but it's playing on my mind that in the future I am going to want to come back and do this, mm-hmm. and that's going to mean putting in the same amount of effort that has been done already to get to this stage.
For me, I think it would be 50% easier with warmer weather, that's all.
Yeah.
That's a good point. You could certainly get good weather if you do it in February or late March even, when it hasn't had as much rain, it would be a lot more pleasant. This is, the bush is soaking wet from past rain, that's all.
Yeah. Go and do it, and then there's another part of me that's in my heart that's just saying, don't fucking do it.
Yeah. I don't know, I've had a bad omen about this trip. I was a bit onside with Huey, but I thought, we have come this far, we should continue on, but this for me is just like how cold I was before at lunch and right now, but. Just in the raft worst, it's like, is it worth it? I don't know.
I feel like if I don't do it this time, like I'll probably never
come back,
yeah.
Wouldn't blame you.
Probably should have just not complicated it and fucking kept the pack rafts out of it, hey? Just gone right over.
Yeah, but the thing is, if it had have been, if I hadn't just popped it, it would have been fine. I would have got down there. At least it'd be fine.
Yeah, but it's extra weight to carry them. Probably not going to be able to utilise them going up the Jane in reality, like looking at this now. Like,
yeah.
All right, so we've decided to continue following the Erebus down to the junction of the Jane, and we're not sure if we're going to continue once we get to the junction, but we appear to be following the old gold track, which was cut in 1909 by Robert Thirkel. And this was the track that they used up until about 1938, I think it was, when the new track was cut in. The one that we walked in yesterday. Horizontal heaven. Oh, this place. Dead end?
No.
Dead end?
Oh, a little bit.
Oh, Banksia.
Hey?
A little Banksia there. A bit different to see something other than a fucking tea tree. Bowra. Button grass. What's the time?
20 to 4.
Fuck. So we've got like an hour and a half to get to the junction of the Erebus and the Jane.
Something like that, yeah. I don't know how thick it is.
This is fucked.
So what do you think? I think if we keep going through all that, which would be that way, and then start going a little bit further west.
So shoot that gap up there.
Yep.
Erebus and the Jane junction. Now I wonder, would we have been able to paddle up that?
Don't start that. Looks good, doesn't it?
Well,
it flows a lot deeper than the Erebus, so it's not as fast moving.
We've still got a repair kit.
Hey?
We've got a repair kit.
We can try and repair it.
Now, the predicament that we have is we need to get all the way over here somewhere. Stannard's grave lies somewhere around this area. Now, if I had to put money on it, I would say that it is this spot right here, purely based on the fact that, according to the 1933 prospecting report, which followed from Calder Pass, then, Council Pass, then along Thirkles Creek and along the Jane, once it hit Stannard's grave, it took a sharp left and went across some button grass plains, and then followed the bank of the Jane all the way to the Erebus Rivulet Junction. So my money is on that spot right there. However, we are all the way over here, which is approximately 5 kilometers or so. And we don't know whether to just do it as a day walk, leave our gear and camp and everything set up here, and just take like an EPIRB, food, raft, jackets, or we take all our gear with us, put in the time, and if we find the grave site tomorrow, then we can continue north up to Thirkles Creek or so, follow Thirkles Creek to where we camped last time, and bust out onto the tea tree there and make our exit that way. Yeah, a few decisions to weigh up. Anyway, need to get some sleep, recharge, and we'll see what happens in the morning. Wet socks, wet boots, and good morning, guys. Today is day 3, and I'm a bit excited. Last night, in my sleep, at around 3:30, I was woken up, and I could hear this barking going on across the other side of the rivulet. And this is thylacine territory. It, Charlin and his party actually found footprints of a thylacine in this area, just down from here, about 500 meters, in a muddy tributary, which was southwest of Warren's Lookout. They, checked it on the map and it wasn't named, and they thought, let's name it, and they drew straws, or sticks, and the dude who won it was Constable Royal. If you were to search Royal Creek on List Map, you would actually find it to be about 5 kilometers north of here in a tributary off the Thirkles Creek. But if you know the story, and you know how Royal Creek got its name, then you would know that Charlin and his party named it, and that was days after they passed through Thirkles Creek, and they'd been down here at the goldfields talking to the prospectors, which, by the way, even after working down here for years, had never personally seen a thylacine. But Charlin and the party still managed to get footprints that are now in the Melbourne Museum. So have a think about that. They're not as common as you'd imagine even 80 years ago. Now let's have some brekkie. Did you hear the thylacine?
I heard the owls.
What time?
This morning, pretty early hours, yeah.
I heard a thyla.
heard the thyla.
It wasn't, it was different noise to the first night.
Wow.
Yeah, I'll play it for you.
All right, so what we've decided is we're gonna pack up here. We're gonna take all our shit and we're gonna follow the north bank of the Jane all the way to Thirkles Creek Junction. That way, we'll hopefully find the grave site and we'll also be able to get a positive ID on the Thirkles and Jane Junction. That's the plan today. Find the grave site, camp at the old Piner's Camp on the junction of the Jane and Thirkles. The next few days after that, don't worry about it.
Get out alive.
We ain't thinking about it yet.
What's the date today, Levi? 28th of April, 2021. The day that Stannard's grave was rediscovered.
Go again, 29th.
Say that again.
My heart's racing with excitement and anxiety and just about everything. Put that on for me, homie.
Yeah, all right, lad.
A little pink water bottle.
Houn Pine. Is that the first one we've seen all trip?
That is the first one.
Another one there.
Well, it seems pretty easy to follow, doesn't it?
Yeah, but for this part here, for the most part, the northern part of the bank,
yep.
It said it followed the bank of the river, so
yep.
That's exactly what we're on, and it's proving to be nice. Oh, check that out.
Wow.
Holy shit. That was cut by Stannard's party for sure.
That's a big one. Look at the size of that.
Wow. That's one that never made it down to Macquarie Harbour.
That's a big Houn log.
Couple of bird's eye Houns here. Huey'd be proud of me. She turns bower up here. But we don't really have much of a choice, eh? The shit has officially hit the fan. We're making our way through this horrible scrub. Bulldozing it. Come across a bit of a knoll here. Definitely not it. Quarter to 12 now. And it's a good thing we brought our packs because this would have been our turning back point. We've only managed to walk that far from the junction, which was down here, which is still about 3 Ks or so in 4 hours. It's pretty slow going.
Done 3.4 K.
So we're still just cruising up the bank of the Jane. We've travelled, according to Levi's tracking app, 4.8 kilometres, which is 3 miles exactly. But there would be probably some zigzagging and extra length added to our route than there would be. compared to the old track. So I think any minute now, walking through here, we could be on. All right, so just found this little spot here. It's a bit of a knoll on the riverbank. Looking very much like it could have been the site where they laid John Stannard to rest. The only thing is there's no Houn pines, and it's probably not it.
Let's keep going.
But it's the most exciting thing we've seen so far, so.
Yeah.
Give us a break, okay?
I mean, from here, it looks like it could be it. I don't think it's a big enough knoll, though. And the track doesn't take a sharp left from here. It just goes straight through.
That's true.
So let's keep rolling.
Rightio.
I don't know. Could it?
Could be.
It's not really a knoll, though, is it?
It's elevated, but it's just the riverbank, the same as the rest of it up here.
Surrounded by beaches, myrtle. Mm. Depends on those trees that were behind. Maybe there's too much going on. 100 years, you can't get pines like that growing, can you?
No way.
So it must be up further.
Too much in there. Too much growth. Pretty spot though.
Very, very similar spot. But I don't think it's it. Come on, give us the knoll. We need it. Can't possibly be on the other side, can it? It just doesn't add up to be on the other side. The track never crossed the river, did it?
Not really, no. We're looking for ruins that are 120 years old.
Yeah, but most importantly, we're looking for the knoll. Because it's not just going to be like some tiny little bump in the ground. Are you feeling what I'm feeling?
Oh, I was just about to say, that looks like it's good. I am feeling what you're feeling. It's elevated.
It's got some knoll about it.
Imagine they are about the same age, and they are honestly looking like they'd be 100 years old. No shit. Check out the distance. Of the... It's just so like they don't. They look so uniform.
There was only 3 of them left, though.
Well, there's 2 now.
I don't know. Unconfirmed.
Unconfirmed.
Another unconfirmed site. Let's keep trucking. Might be ahead. I honestly feel like we would have seen it.
We would have seen it.
Yeah.
It's going to be obvious. More I obvious think than, so. Than we're.
But I just.
We're just so desperate with the. 2 massive trips and we want it so bad.
I know. There's still unexplored ground though before we connect to the last mission. Fuck. That's circles. That means we've gone past it. Oh well, we tried. So here's where we are, that little blue dot. And that's Thirkles Creek, right there. We're at the old Piners camp. And last time we were here, we came down Thirkles, and then Thirkles diverted south, and we lost it. So we headed over to the Jane, and we explored down the Jane before we crossed over, and followed our way down on the western side to these potential null spots, as you can see there in the topography. And then we got down to this point here and crossed over on the raft. We then headed back up on foot
trying to find this blue line, which was Thirkles Creek, and found nothing. After that, we went up to here, Levi and I did, and then came back and camped. So we've searched all of that area. The only area that hasn't been searched is a little bit north from here, and then these couple of pockets.
I'm just thinking, like, is there anything else we could do here to try and find it?
A little bit of ground north.
A little bit of ground north, but that's it. Once we get to the point that we reached last time, like...
Is there anything that makes it up in document that I've said that is south of Thirkles, like...
Not really, except it was 6 miles from Calder and 3 miles from Erebus, which basically puts it about here. Like, we're in the zone.
Yeah.
I'm thinking maybe we didn't go inland enough, because you did say a short distance in from the river. Mm. It wasn't on the river.
Yeah, that's what I was wrong about. I just thought, oh, what if he's 50 metres back, or even 20, because we were in the 10-metre, 15-metre zone.
But it doesn't look that way from the photo.
Nah.
It looks like he's on the river.
To the river down below, doesn't it?
Mm.
With all that light overexposed photo is.
Yeah. Unless it's an illusion and it was taken in like a little myrtle grove and behind that was just open forest and it was overexposed. So it was in the shadows. So
yeah, that's always a possibility too.
Please, just let it be
just
it.
Just give us something. Two humans. These guys are too close to... Oh, no.
Bit of a null. That's it. It's confirmed, mate. I'll see you later. We've done it.
Go home.
All right, we've now officially covered all the ground on the eastern bank, which concludes the search. It's time to set up camp somewhere and get ready for the walkout tomorrow. Part one of two of the walkout tomorrow. Looking at the map, and I thought I'll have a quick look at the picture of Stannard's grave and check what date he died. And it was April 29th, 1901. So it was exactly 120 years today.
Serious?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember the April now that you mentioned it.
April 29th.
On the picture.
There you go.
That is insane.
That's spooky because this trip's been held back for months.
Yeah.
And we finally got an opportunity to do it, and here we are.
It was just this window of weather, eh?
Yeah.
And today was the destined search day, and I fucking never thought twice about that.
We didn't even think about it.
Nah. Unreal.
That's so cool.
Done it. This is it. Made it back to the day 3 camp from last trip. Our little clearing. Probably can't see much because there's so much moisture. Everything's saturated.
Oh. Well, what a freaking day. Massive, massive day. With no grave site. So yeah, that sucks a bit. A bit disappointed in it. Took so much effort to get down here with the new clues. I thought it was foolproof, honestly. I thought there's no way that we won't see at least the knoll and a couple of the Houns or anyway, the only thing we've really thought might have happened is it's further inland than just the riverbank, but could have also have been completely washed away. So what used to be a knoll is a big flat mess now or something. Who knows? My life.
Hey Levi. There is another way this story could end.
Yeah.
We leave our tent set up and we go back down light and find that fucker today. It is ambitious, isn't it? But it wouldn't hurt us, like physically, to have a bit of a rest day.
Yeah.
And it'd also give us a higher chance at researching the area and putting it to rest.
Yeah.
Even if we didn't use the whole day.
Go again.
Even if we didn't use the whole day searching, like if we got back here at lunchtime, we could leave.
Yeah. Yep.
I don't know. It's just a thought, because the forecast is pretty good still.
Uh-huh.
So if we want to buy another day, we can do that.
Yep.
Or we can just get the hell out of here.
We could do it. I'm not against the idea. Just do it. I hadn't thought of it. I hadn't thought of it at all, that's all. I had my heart set on home.
So did I, and then I thought,
let's do it.
What's stopping us, like, staying?
Yeah.
Is just the idea that we don't, like, I don't know.
All I got to say to the missus now, because I told her Saturday night is just say running behind schedule, so could spend another day not find it. This fuck is hard to find.
Mm.
Why didn't we just see it there somewhere?
How much bad scrub was there, like, between here and that little...
Oh, it was fine from here to back to... The hot zone was all good.
The cliff bit.
Mm.
After that cliff bit kind of got good, didn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it'd be there. It'd just be around that button grass area where we thought it would be. Where it's possible to take a sharp left and head across button grass.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like Thurkles Creek is halfway between here and there. I don't know, it might be a 3-hour search.
Yeah, no, I reckon we could, with it travelling light, we'd get down there and back by 1 o'clock.
Mm. What'd they say about the forecast?
That sounds good, doesn't it?
60% chance of rain for Sunday. 18 degrees. So even if we get a few showers, we're going to be wet on the way out anyway. Mm. We know that.
Yeah.
So we do have another day if we want it. We're here.
Come this far.
We've done all the work. The only thing is we kind of just we know how tormenting it is to have to backtrack, but it's 10 times as hard or 100 times as hard to have to get back here from home.
Again,
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it's not the backtracking for me. It's just the time, extra day away. But, yeah, I'm happy to do it. I'm easy. Let's find him.
So this is where we are. We've come all the way down. It's taken us 2 hours. And we're right here on my favorite little spot. And it's amazing through here. Just chewing pine everywhere. And just a heap of little islands scattered around the place, separated by these little streams. There's the Jane. Now where's Stannard?
Look at this.
Stannard put his initials in the tree.
Pretty much. It's been cut, but never fell.
Oh wow.
Isn't that crazy?
That's cool. There's a cool bit of history. I'll take the cobwebs out. Get a better view. So they cut it 120 years ago. And you can see how it's all grown back out here.
Yeah. Very close to...
I left him. You nearly went down. Houn, you nearly became a ship down at Hobart. Someone's furniture.
Why did they stop though?
Stannard slipped. They were like, shit.
Someone could have been working this one and they were like, oi, come here.
Stannard's dead.
That's a really nice, good, solid piece of straight Houn. I can't understand that. And they went all the way to it almost fall. For it to almost fall.
I don't think the heel's right, is it? Doesn't feel right. Just the back of it.
Such a good gnoll. Very gnarly. And in the right spot, like distance wise, this is just the perfect distance from the 2 points. Being Calder Pass and Erebus. See, I reckon when we walked through here, we went down below the river before. Because we know just through those trees is the scrubby button grass plains. Why'd they take this log?
Small, isn't it?
That's tiny. They wouldn't have felled that.
SD.
Why did they cut that? I reckon this is what they made the headstone out of. Has to be, right? We're on a knoll. Where the track can turn left and head over button grass plains. They've cut this tiny Houn pine here. Which is about just big enough to be able to make a headstone out of.
Oh my God, Levi, come here. What have you found? A bottle? We'll come over here, mate, because I just found the fucking cross saw. Oh my God. Holy shit. Look at this. That's a cross saw, mate. And this is the top.
That's the top half
of Stannard's grave.
They're the Houns.
They are the Houns. We did it! Yes! Oh my God! Have a sip of this. Dude, this is so far from the river, but it's on the knoll. Like, it all makes sense. Oh my God. So, and look. It's gone. The headstone's gone, but the main piece is still there. And the crosscut saw is there. Dude, we did it.
I cannot
believe. We stayed and we did it.
I cannot believe this, man.
This is the happiest day in my life, brother. We have done it. We have fucking done it, dude. Can you believe this? If we didn't do this today, we would have never done it ever. We wouldn't have come back. I was not coming back, dude.
This is a needle in a haystack.
Too, it's though. Beyond a needle in a haystack. Look at what it is.
You can see where it was. I cut that out there, look.
It is just...
It's got crust. There's been nothing. Like, there's been this bottle. When I seen this bottle, that for me was like a massive shock because we haven't seen anything other than cut logs and... You know, like where there's been axes, a little bit of foot traffic. There's been nothing. No metal,
I can't believe. I stumbled over that barra and I was like, oh, I wonder what's over here. And so, I was looking down. I looked around at these Houns and I was like, this is a bit odd. Like, yeah, it's making sense, but a million places it's made sense.
Yeah.
And then I saw that cross cut and I went, Levi, come over here. And you were like, no, you come over here.
I was just like, I didn't believe you. I was just like, is this another wild story, man?
This has been a wild story, dude. This has been the wildest story.
Up until now, we've just been like half effort, like, oh, that could be it. That could be it. We've had nothing.
How crazy is it that we found that?
I'm standing on the floor, guy.
How crazy is it that we found that cut off log? And I was like, nah, I reckon they made the headstone out of this. And it's here.
That's amazing. That's amazing.
Like, it took all the clues of everything to pinpoint to here, and then even once we got here, then we found more clues.
Branching out, going across the Buttongrass Plain, direct line to the Elvis Rivulet. This is like, I want to drink this, but
I think we should have a celebratory sip, man. Oh, I'm just going to turn the cam off and chill. Yeah.
He was here this time of the morning, like.
Well, he talked about the sunlight hitting the ground.
Yeah,
because it was in like a bit of a grove, but in the photograph you can see the overexposure, which just perfectly matches that, which is what caught us off, because we thought that overexposure was the river.
Yeah, that's
but
right.
As it was a gap between this little hill and then flatland, then the river. Mm-hmm. So we walked straight past this hill yesterday.
We were just down this little knoll on the other side. So they've basically buried him on the backside of the knoll rather than the riverside.
Yep.
And that's how we've missed him.
But we came back for the re-up, homie.
Back. I'm glad you got me back here, man.
You owe me.
Because I was very close to not wanting to, I tell you.
You were hating it, dude.
My attitude this morning wasn't the best when he said, let's go back and have another look. I was like, what? I can't believe he's saying that, but... It's incredible. Look at the perfect gap where the plaque was. You can see here. I need to have a look on this. It's a bit hard to make out on camera, but you can see where they've cut into this bit of timber right down to that point there. And it's just wide enough for that headstone to have been.
I wonder where it
nailed
is.
Nailed on, or
even though some bugger shook it, I wonder
if it's nearby. Wonder it's if made it... a Houn, and it'd be. Be amazing to sit it.
Chances back. Are it would be probably nearby.
It'd be amazing to sit it right back there.
Nice. And just to show how easy it is to lose this, if I was to just go 5 meters over here, there's no way you'd spot it. Walk straight past it easy.
Found a needle in a haystack.
Well, I think that it's harder to find this than it would be than a needle in a haystack. A needle in a hay barn
maybe
would be the equivalent, yes. Anyway. Wonder if there's any other relics over there. Must have been a camp. Little camping spot next to the river, maybe. Mm.
Cool, man. The bottom is there too. There you go.
Thank you. Great job, homie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We did it. Came and conquered. Now it's time to
head home.
Head home. Head back to camp.
Now it's time to get home and say bye, Stannard.
We could nearly get home in
a better GPS.
2 days.
Yeah, we can still do it.
Maybe.
Because we're excited now.
Yeah, we've got victory in our bloods. That's why.
It looks so cool from here. You can just see so much human organization, the way it was all laid out.
Yeah.
Dunk, dunk, dunk.
Amazing. Dunk. Yeah, let's see what it looks like in another century, hey? We know the location now. It's not easy to get to. It's definitely not easy to get to. 3 days, nonstop. Packed pop rafts, busted knees, twisted ankles, bruises, lack of sleep, just eating non-stop because we're so stressed out. Fear of going home without
finding
success.
It. We were so depressed last night.
We were so depressed. But hey, we're here. We did it. We made it.
Rob went to bed at 8 o'clock last night.
8? It was like 6:30.
No, it was 7.
Seven, yeah.
It was 7.
I had nothing to say. I was just done.
You were done for the day.
All right.
I didn't even document anything from yesterday because I was just so depressed. That's why I gave you the update this morning. I'm so glad we're here, though.
Listen to him. I'm so depressed.
Shut up.
What would you do if we woke up in our tents right now and it was pissing down with rain? And this was all just a dream. Sorry?
Wouldn't be good, would it?
I'd set off the EPIRB.
I've never been so loved. Life feels like the longest part. Even though eternity is ours. And on our way to streets of gold, we'll savor every mile of this road.
The overtake. Road lights in front. Leaves the NRS behind. He's going for the gap. And he shot it.
And then there's a big log there.
No, I want to see the skeleton. It's not the gold.
You're a sick man, Levi.
Sick man. You gave me that at least.
No, no, I wouldn't do that.
Wait, Fussy.
Hey.
Don't ignore me, you little like shit. Every moment
counts. Here on earth, little thylacine layer in here. Treasure in the gift of borrowed
time. We're not where we're going, and we're not a copy of my style, mate. Taking the long
way. Erin got the same sleeping bag as me, and when we're up at like Nameless, we put them together. Oh, your sleeping bag smells like the Jane River.
I was like, yeah, it's pretty bad. I haven't washed it since.
Yeah,
keep it in here.
Eat shit on camera.
First people to see this in, well, a long time. I would go as far as to say this millennium, actually.
Steamy ass sock.
No, you've said it.
How are you going to do this with a straight face? How are you going to do this with a straight face?
Is it filming?
Yep.
This is the top of Stenard's grade. They are the Houns.
We did it!
Oh my god! Dude, this is so far from the river, but it's on the knoll. Like, it all makes sense.
Oh my god.
So, and look.
You bastards!
That piece is still there.
Oh, I'm so fucking happy for you.
To the other side.